Hello, my name is Sean Montgomery, and it's a great pleasure to be playing for you today. The first piece that I'm going to play for you is Parry's Fantasia and Fugue in G major. Parry had a lifelong interest in the organ. As a schoolboy at Twyford School in Hampshire, he was acquainted with S.S. Wesley, who would often invite him into the organ loft at nearby Winchester Cathedral. At Eton, he studied the organ with the chapel organist at St. George's, Windsor, and whilst reading law in Oxford in 1867, studied with the organist of New College. So, given his interest in the instrument and his prolific output as a composer, it's perhaps surprising that he didn't write any music for the organ until 1910, when he was in his 60s. Parry admired the music of Brahms, whose set of 11 organ chorale preludes, published in 1902, may well have been the inspiration Parry was looking for to start writing for the organ. And in 1911, Parry wrote his own set of organ chorale preludes. A very, very positive reaction encouraged Parry to write more organ music, including three large fantasias and the Fantasia and Fugue in G major, which I'm going to play for you now. It's a beautifully crafted piece and displays a deeply English quality, influenced by Parry's love of German music, in particular Brahms and Bach. In fact, the influence of Bach is very obvious in the Fantasia. Conceived with a large instrument in mind, this is a real gem and a fine example of British organ music of the period.
Thank you.
The second piece I'm going to play for you is Hindemith's Organ Sonata No. 1. So why is it, do you think, that all organ music of any significance has been written by composers who are also organists? Well, almost certainly, it's because the organ is one of the most complex instruments to compose for. But this didn't deter Hindemith, who wrote a collection of quality pieces, including three organ sonatas, which have become an integral part of 20th century organ literature. But what was the secret to his success? Hindemith approached the organ not as a specialist, but with the wealth of experience that he'd built up as a composer of music for all of the main orchestral instruments. Indeed, he wrote sonatas for pretty much all of them. He had a deep interest in the Baroque and classical periods, which included not just the music, but the organs as well. Organs that created a clear and transparent sound that were easy to write for, rather than the complex symphonic instruments of the Romantic period. But I think the main reason that makes Hindemith's organ music so special is his unique harmonic language. And it's his own system based on fourths and fifths rather than the third. And this allows the music to pass very easily between major and minor modes. It's also a system that's driven a lot by melody and linear counterpoint. So chords are merely the product of the combination of the moving melodic lines. So this makes for some spectacular harmony and for a truly unique musical language. So the first sonata, which I'm going to play for you now, was composed in 1937, and it's in two movements, which divide into a number of clear-cut sections, each of which have their own unique style and character. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. The final piece I'd like to play for you today is Fiat Lux by Dubois. Dubois was a conductor, an organist, a teacher, and one of the leading Parisian composers of the 19th century. He served as organist of several major Paris churches in Paris, and was also sometime director of the Paris Conservatoire. He wrote music for the theatre, the church, the concert, and the recital hall. As an organist himself, he made a considerable contribution to the organ repertoire. In 1892, at the request of his publisher, Dubois composed a set of 12 new pieces for the organ designed to demonstrate the resources of a large organ. Now, the eighth piece from that set is Fiat Lux, and that translates as Let There Be Light. It's an exuberant toccata during which the music moves as if it were from darkness to light, ending on a blaze of sound using the full resources of this magnificent organ.